Welcome to evening prayer with the Stamford Methodist Circuit for Monday the 15th of April. In our circuit online evening prayers last week, my colleague the Reverend Ruth Charlesworth focused on people of the resurrection. Our theme for evening prayers this week, Alive in Christ, follows on from that. It's the theme suggested by the Methodist Church Prayer Handbook alongside our scripture readings, which are taken from St. Paul's letter to the Romans. For our call to worship, we hear the final words of the psalm recommended for today by the Methodist Church Prayer Handbook, Psalm 118. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, and I will extol you. O give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures for ever. Let us pray. We praise you, O God, for this joyful Eastertide, as we celebrate again the great redemption won for us by our Lord Jesus Christ and his victory over death. Grant us by your grace to enter into that triumph, to share his risen life, and at last to be partakers of his endless joy, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In a few moments, we'll hear our scripture reading from Romans chapter 4, in which St. Paul draws on the experience of Abraham to point to the importance of faith, and especially at the end of our reading, faith in God who raised Jesus from the dead. To prepare us for hearing that reading, we share a contemporary arrangement of some of the words of the ancient hymn, The God of Abraham Prays. In this version, compiled by Music Ministries during the COVID-19 lockdown, the vocalist is John Bartholomew, and the other musicians and contributors to the recording are Heather Cowan, Joe and Pat Crossley, and Matt Dennis.
The God of Abraham prays, who reigns enthroned above, Ancient of everlasting days and God of love, Jehovah great I am, by earth and heaven confessed, I bow and bless the sacred name forever. Sworn, I on this oath depend, I shall on eagle's wings upborne to heaven ascend, I shall behold God's face, I shall God's power adore, and sing the wonders of God's grace forevermore. The heavenly land I see, with peace and plenty blessed, a land of sacred liberty and death. Sing, and holy, holy, holy Christ. cry, Almighty King, who was and is to come, and evermore shall be, Jehovah Lord, the great I Am. We worship Thee, who was and is to come, and evermore shall be, Jehovah Lord, the great I Am. We worship Thee. Worship Thee. Yeah.
We hear Romans chapter 4, verses 13 to 25, read for us by David Suchet from the New International Version of the Bible.
It was not through the law that Abraham and his offspring received the promise that he would be heir of the world, but through the righteousness that comes by faith. For if those who depend on the law are heirs, faith means nothing, and the promise is worthless, because the law brings wrath. And where there is no law, there is no transgression. Therefore, the promise comes by faith, so that it may be by grace and may be guaranteed to all Abraham's offspring, not only to those who are of the law, but also to those who have the faith of Abraham. He is the father of us all. As it is written, I have made you a father of many nations. He is our father in the sight of God, in whom he believed, the God who gives life to the dead and calls into being things that were not. Against all hope, Abraham in hope believed, and so became the father of many nations, just as it had been said to him, so shall your offspring be. Without weakening in his faith, he faced the fact that his body was as good as dead, since he was about 100 years old, and that Sarah's womb was also dead. Yet he did not waver through unbelief regarding the promise of God, but was strengthened in his faith, and gave glory to God, being fully persuaded that God had power to do what he had promised. This is why it was credited to him as righteousness. The words, it was credited to him, were written not for him alone, but also for us, to whom God will credit righteousness, for us who believe in him who raised Jesus our Lord from the dead. He was delivered over to death for our sins and was raised to life for our justification.
There's rather a lot to unpack in that reading, and to help us with that unpacking, we need to remember that the background is the covenant which God made and ratified with Abraham, recorded for us in the book of Genesis. St. Paul refers back to that covenant, quoting directly from Genesis chapter 17 and verse 5, in which Abraham, whose name means exalted father, has his name changed by God to Abraham, which means father of many. For St. Paul, no Old Testament character exemplified genuine faith better than did Abraham, who wasn't just the father of one nation, but of many nations. As St. Paul wrote in Romans 4:16, Abraham is the father of us all. Abraham has been called the prototype of faith for all who believe, Jews and Gentiles alike. From Abraham, Paul derives one of his most significant doctrines, that of justification by faith. For Paul, the significance of faith exceeds or transcends the principle of keeping the Jewish law as the foundation for the relationship between God and his people. Therefore, for Paul, there is essentially no difference between faith placed in Jesus by those from non-Jewish backgrounds and the faith placed in Jesus by those who claimed they could trace their Jewish ancestry back to Abraham. for Paul, faith in Jesus is ultimately faith in one and the same God who was Abraham's God. The God who renewed Abraham's life in his old age and brought new life from Sarah's dead womb is the same God who raised Jesus from the dead, and in whom those who have faith in Jesus are also alive in Christ. Abraham trusted that what God had promised, God would bring about. And ultimately, that's the promise of salvation, which we receive by faith, but which is first and foremost a gift of God's grace. We continue to reflect on that as we hear a recording by singers from the Salvation Army's Regent Hall in London of the worship song, Only by Grace Can We Enter.
Only by grace can we enter.
Gracious God, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who became a human being so that we may have life. Help your church to continue to seek that fullness of life, which is found in Jesus and which is for all people. Today and always, open our eyes to see you making all things new for us as individuals, our communities and the world. In Jesus' name, Amen. We pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We often end our times of worship by saying together the words which we refer to as the grace. Sometimes we say those words looking at each other as we do so, in an act of blessing each other. We can trace the words of the grace back to St. Paul, and specifically to the end of his second letter to the Corinthians. However, St. Paul includes a greeting or blessing prayer for God's grace in all of the letters which bear his name in the New Testament. Therefore, we shall end our prayer times each evening this week by sharing the words of the grace as a blessing for one another, as, unseen by each other, we share this prayer as an online community of faith. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you for sharing in this time of prayer. God bless you.